Hi, I'm Caleb Horst for CellScale Biomaterials Testing. I wanted to talk a little bit about testing soft gels using the CellScale MicroSquisher test system. And I thought the best way to do that would be to do an example, to take some soft gel and test it in a number of different ways using the system. So I took agar gel, and what I did was the first thing, I cast that liquid gel inside of a soft tube that had a 2 millimeter inside diameter. And I allowed the gel to solidify inside that tube. And once I removed it from there, I had a cylinder that was 2 millimeters in diameter, which I could cut to length. And I cut that to 4.7 millimeters long. And I was able to do a parallel plate compression test on those small cylinders. So I had a fixed lower plate and came in with the force sensing upper plate and did a compression on that cylinder and measured the force and displacement to do that, from which I was able to get stress and strain by dividing the force by the cross-sectional area of the cylinder. The second thing I was able to do was to take that liquid agar and dribble it into a column of chilled oil. And as the agar enters the oil, the surface tension drives it into a spherical shape and it settles in the oil. By the time it reaches the bottom of the chilled oil container, it's already formed a gel. So I'm left with a collection of spheres at the bottom of the container of different diameters. And I selected some spheres, 2 to 3 millimeters in size, and much like the cylinder, I did a parallel plate compression test of the spheres, and using some formulas to get the stress-strain behavior, I was able to get a modulus based on the parallel plate compression of the spheres. The last thing I did was take that liquid agar and pour it into a container and let it gel as a plane. And I couldn't test the plane and parallel plate compression, but what I did was did an indentation test where I took the force probe of the MicroSquisher and I added a 3 millimeter diameter stainless steel ball and pushed that ball into the flat horizontal surface that I had made by pouring the agar into the container. And I was able to get the force displacement of pushing that ball into the plane. And there are, again, formulas. You can see on our website there's a white paper that talks about the formulas. To get the force, the stress and strain behavior based on the force displacement of pushing that ball into the plane. And doing all three of these test methods, I was able to get the same value for the modulus of the material at about 12 kilopascals, so relatively soft gel. And I just wanted to do that and present that as a way to sort of validate the different things that can be done with the MicroSquisher. Not every type of material lends itself to being able to test in all three different ways. But I thought it would be useful for other people to see what can be done and what's possible. Of course, if you have any questions about this kind of thing, or your material, or other ways to use the force probe on the MicroSquisher, we'd be more than happy to talk with you. Or if you have more questions about this particular study, if everything's not clear in the white paper, please contact CellScale. We'd be happy to talk to you about it. Thanks.